हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर रंजीत सिंह वंस अगेन विद यू। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू अ ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द रोमांटिक एज, सो दैट व्हेन आई डील विद दिस रोमांटिसिज्म इन डिटेल यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट क्लियरली। द रोमांटिक एज इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द रनिशा ऑफ वंडर और द एज ऑफ विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ। द रोमांटिक मूवमेंट कैन नॉट बी गिवन अ प्रिसाइज डेट। इट डेवलप्ड स्लोली till it came to a head in the year 1798. And the event that gave a definite shape and direction to the movement was the publication of Lyrical Ballads. And you know that Lyrical Ballads was a joint effort of William Wordsworth and S.T. Coleridge. The beginning of Romanticism may be traced back to the early part of the 18th century. Wordsworth and Coleridge did not create or initiate it. They only gave a definite shape to Romanticism, which had manifested itself long before in the works of the 18th century poets like Thomson, Gray, William Collins, Thomas Gray, Robert Burns. That's why these poets are called the precursors of the new movement. There is the first glimmering of Romanticism in their poetry. They were living in an age dominated by classical ideals. But both in form and sentiment, their work show a new trend. The heroic couplet was replaced by the expensive stanza and Miltonic blank verse. And love of nature, humanism, lyric and elegiac note and a new interest in the medieval past reappeared in English poetry. Romanticism is also called the revival of Elizabethan Romanticism. The term Romantic Revival is applied to the splendid outburst of literature in the age of Wordsworth. The word revival indicates a return to literature of those romantic qualities which had characterized the literature of the Elizabethan age. The Romanticism of Elizabethan age was the expression of the imaginative life which had been stimulated by the Ranisha. Unbridled imagination, the glow of passion and emotion, the joy of newfound freedom, and the power of mind are the main characteristics of the Elizabethan theatre. In the poetry of Spenser, in the plays of Marlowe and William Shakespeare, and the prose of Francis Bacon, these qualities found their supreme expression. The unrestrained freedom and exuberance of the Elizabethans was subjected to scrutiny and criticism in Augustan age. The new spirit involved the substitution of the critical for the imaginative spirit. It brought intellect into play rather than poetic imagination. The leading writers of the age in the classical period gave up the extravagance and emotionalism. They called themselves the Augustans, so the Augustans laid stress on the cultivation of simplicity, clarity, propriety, decorum, moderation, perfect finish, good sense, and reason. Elizabethan picturesqueness, suggestiveness, and sensuousness, liberalism, and sensibility had no place in the classical age. The poetry of this time was confined to high society and to my lords and ladies. It has nothing to do with the countryside or nature, and with the life of remote times and places. The result was that the fundamental qualities of great poetry were altogether suppressed, and the form of verse that developed in the age was satire only. The age is called the classical age in literature. So in the later half of the 18th century, there was a natural revolt against the classical spirit of the 18th century, which had given rise to artificiality in poetry, both in regard to subject matter and style. This spirit of revolt was accentuated by the French Revolution, with its cry of liberty, equality, and fraternity. What the Ranisha had done to the release of the human mind from the bondage of the church and medieval scholasticism, the French Revolution did in a large measure in the social and political spheres. The ideals of French Revolution inspired men's minds and inflamed their souls. The same unbridled imagination, the same glow of passion that had characterized Elizabethan literature but revived in the literature of the age of Wordsworth. Hence, the literary movement known as the Romantic Revival was on the one hand a revolt against the classical creed of the 18th century, and on the other hand, it was a revival of the romantic spirit of the Elizabethan age. Since the spirit of romantic poetry was very much related to that of the Elizabethan age, the Elizabethan literary forms of poetry and subjects were also revived again in the romantic era, like the sonnet, the lyric, the pastoral, the blank verse drama, the Spenserian stanza, the ballad, etc. The same fullness of imagination, richness of language, vastness of conception, lyricism, and picturesqueness, suggestiveness, and sensuousness which permeated the great Elizabethan works are found again in the literature, especially poetry in the age of Wordsworth. Some writers have given their definitions while defining Romanticism or Romantic Age. Theodore Watts Dunton has said that Romanticism is the Renaissance of wonder. And Walter Pater has said that Romanticism is an addition of strangeness to beauty. These are two very popular definitions of Romanticism. So this Romanticism is used for the mysterious and unexplored beauty of the Middle Ages. Sometimes for the unheard melodies expressed in the poetry of Shelley and Keats, for the expression of the novelty and mystery in commonplace objects of men, nature and human life, as in the poetry of Wordsworth, for the majestic revelation of earthly touch in things mysterious and uncommon, as in the supernatural poetry of Coleridge, for the fiercely passionate and rebellious poetry of Lord Byron, or for the historical novels of Walter Scott. Just for the desire of creating an ideal world, the ivory tower as a citadel of relief from the maddening strife of the crowd. We can also discuss a few characteristics that will define this Romanticism or Romantic Age in a much better way. Like sense of mystery, the romantic spirit seeks the strange and mysterious and reveals the wonder of things removed from real life. According to the romantics, there are more things in heaven and earth than are perceived in the ordinary course of life. And it is this feeling that arouses their curiosity in the unearthly and the supernatural. S.T. Coleridge described the feeling of wonder and mystery in the supernatural. And William Wordsworth revealed the inherent mystery in the common objects of nature and human life. Whereas Shelley, he spiritualized nature. The romantics had a great interest in the past. So the romantics sought to get away from the pressure of the present reality, just to find modes of deliverance from the dead weight of routine, from the hectic schedule of life. So they looked for the past, because the past was remote from present realities. And it is remoteness and distance that lends a wonder and enchantment to the panorama of life. That's why the romantics went back, especially to the Middle Ages. Like Sir Walter Scott, he embraced history. So history embraced by the Romanticism gave birth to historical novel, which fascinated Sir Walter Scott. Coleridge, Scott and Keats, they dealt with the past and the Middle Ages. The romantic poets, they had a great love for nature. The romantics discovered a new beauty and wonder in the world of nature. The romantic poets were all lovers of nature. They minutely observed nature in all her aspects and expressed in poetry their emotional reactions to her beauty and magic. William Wordsworth was the first of the romantics to discover a new wonder in nature. Coleridge, Lord Byron, P.B. Shelley and Keats all loved nature and represented her beauty and grandeur from different points of view. Wordsworth found brooding and tranquilizing thought at the heart of nature. Shelley, an ardent and persuasive love in nature. In other words, if I say, they all together spiritualize nature. The Romantics took great interest in humanity and dealt with the lives of common men and women. In the New Classical period, if you remember, it was the life of the upper class of the people that was dealt with in poetry or in literature. Whereas in the Romantic era, it was the essential character of men as men that interested the Romantic poets. Their hearts overflow with sympathy for the poor and the downtrodden. The Romantic poets, they glorified the innocence and simplicity of the common man. They found the divine in man, pleaded for the emancipation from all bondages, and claimed equal rights and liberties for the humble people. The humanitarian philosophy of Rousseau and the ideal of French Revolution spearheaded the democratic movement. The doctrine of liberty, equality, and brotherhood inspired the poets of this age. William Wordsworth, Coleridge, Shelley, and Byron, they all were humanists while dealing with subject matters in their poetry. The Romantic poets, they wanted freedom of imagination in literature because imagination is the cardinal characteristic of Romanticism. It is the freeing or unfretting of passions or emotions in art and letters. The artist is not bound down by any law, rule, apart from the law prescribed by the law of his own artistic genius. It is a revolt against the stereotyped conventions of art and gives a free play to imagination. All the Romantic poets were subjective while composing the poetry. So subjectivity and spontaneity were the basic features of writing. The Romantics were concerned not so much with the external facts of life as with their own feelings and emotions. Poetry to the Romantic poets was the spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings. It is the poet's own emotions that finds expression in his poetry. That's why while writing poems, Shelley becomes personal in his poem Towards Carida. And John Keats, he also becomes personal while writing his odes. Then in the Romantic era, there was a regeneration of poetic style. Poetic style acquired a rich variety in the hands of Romantics. Their interest in the past led them to experiment with old meters and poetic forms. The heroic couplet of the 18th century gave place to various stanza forms. The Spenserian stanza, the ballad, the blank verse, the lyric, the ode, and the sonnet were all revived in the Romantic era. The metrical peculiarities of the old ballad gave fresh inspiration to great poets like Coleridge and Keats. A richness in language and a variety in metrical forms created a new melody in English poetry. Wordsworth, with his simple and natural style, Coleridge, with his wonderful music, Lord Byron, with his vigorous and oratorical style, Shelley with his rich harmonies, and Keats with his picturesque bird painting, gave to English poetry a style which was unique in its range and sweep, as well as in its grace and movement. So my dear friends, this was all about today's lecture. I hope you must have understood the Romanticism and its basic features. In one of my coming lectures, I will also deal with the influence of French Revolution on Romanticism. So thank you for today. Thank you. Thank you.